Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this series I'm going to be going over how you can use Discord.js to create your own Discord bot. In this first video, we're going to be simply creating our bot and getting it set up in a testing server. So if you go to discord.com/developers, or if you click on the link in the description, you should land on a page like this. Here we see my previous applications. We're going to ignore these though. If we go to new application at the top right, we can then specify a name. Mine will be tutorial. We can then click on create. And now we have our bot here. If we go over to the bot tab on the left here, we click on add bot and click on yes. We now have an actual bot here. We can click to reveal this token. And this is a token we're actually going to be using to allow our bot to actually work. Now, you obviously don't want to use this exact one. I'm going to regenerate it as soon as I'm done recording this video, and you don't want to share your own, but you can click on copy to copy this. We'll come back to this soon. For now, we want to go to our OAuth2 section. We want to go to our scopes. We want to check on bot right here. We could then copy this entire URL and we can open this in a new tab. We then want to connect this to a Discord server. I'm going to go ahead and add this to the warrenoffkeys Discord server. I'm going to create a private testing channel in there so we can go ahead and test out some features with the bot. We can click on authorize. We have to make sure that I'm not a robot, and then it should say authorized. So inside of the Discord, we now see the tutorial bot is in here. It says I'm new to Discord, that's expected, and we see that it's a bot. So now we're going to go ahead and create a new channel in here. This will just be for testing. We're going to make this a private channel where only owners can see it. I'm then going to go back to the tutorial bot and I'm going to give it the owner role. So it'll then have access to everything and we can now see it has access to the testing channel. So now we're going to go into VS Code. I've created a folder for our project. And if we navigate to that folder in your console, we can then see we have an empty folder here. We're going to run npm init-y. This will initialize the project. We can then right-click new file. We'll call it index.js. So now we can actually import Discord.js. We can do that by first installing it using npm install discord.js. And then we can import that into our file, const discord equals require discord.js. I'm then going to create a new file. This will be called config.json. This file is going to hold some information such as our token. And I'm creating a separate file here. That way I can actually push this to a GitHub repository. And I don't actually have to worry about this token being pushed there because I can add it to a gitignore file. If we just hard code it into index, which is not recommended at all, then I can't actually push this to a GitHub repository or share it with people without exposing the actual login token. So if we go back to the bot tab, we click on copy. We can then go to config. We can paste it in here. And I want to actually import the config. Require config.json. We now want to create a new Discord client. So we can say constant client equals new discord.client. We're then going to say client.on ready. We're going to have a callback here. And we're simply going to say console.log. The client is ready. And then in order to actually log in, we're going to say client.login. And then we want to pass in the token. So config.token. And if we save this, and if we save our config file, we can go back to our console. We can run it with node index. And I realize I made a mistake. This C should be capitalized here. If we save that and we run it again with node index, we see the client is ready. If we go back to Discord, we see tutorial is now online. So our Discord bot seems to be running. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can actually host this off of your computer for free using AWS. This is something that is a free hosting service for 1 year if you have not used AWS before. And in future videos after that, I'm going to be diving deep into how to actually use every part of Discord.js. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the warrenoffkeys Discord, which can be found in the video description.